Ding. Game, boys. That's game. Dun, dun, dun. Oh, that son of a beast stole our Mox Diamond. We took fixing over it. Mox Diamond would be okay in our deck, but not, like, insane. It basically powers out channels and, like, a little early Domries and stuff, but we don't have a super high land count. So, I'm pretty sure I'm just playing this on turn two. Which is why I led with the forest. Basically, I'm looking to draw an additional green source for the next couple turns. That is not... So this will... I can still Domri, it's not a big deal. Not that I'm going to Domri. I could actually play this. Oh, I could play this. That'll give my guy haste. It's gonna be insane. Yeah, you got it, bro. Swamp, plains. So I'm just going to take the damage off this. Oh, I shouldn't. Oh, that was. Okay. So now I have to get a Mirror Battlesphere. But that's fine. Mirror Battlesphere might be better anyway. Because losing my force would have probably been a bad idea. What are we discarding? We discard Woolies. Woolly deal. Oh. LHJ Foctaro. I kind of want to do that. I can get Witness back channel if I really want to. I should have played this. Play around Spell Pierce. I can't make a Domri. 3, 4, 5. Yes. No, I'm being gotten by my throat. So I obviously want to give it haste. Not that it matters, stupid game face. Alright, so I can tutor up a witness to get back that channel to kill him with Devil's Play if he takes a bunch of damage. Otherwise, I could just play Domri and fight something and go about my merry way. Deck's pretty sweet, I think. Got an island. It's got an archangel thing. Just gonna fight that with the. Mirror Battlesphere. His guy's gonna be bigger. I guess I should attack first. Because he'll easily jump block here. now I can make these guys fight. I could just Devil's Play his thing. Is that better than Domri? I don't think so. Getting a Domri into play is pretty sweet. He probably still would have chump blocked in that situation with a 2-4. But I'll give him the option. Maze of Ith. Well, at least this guy gets in 4 damage. I want to discard this Polycranos, probably. To get a Kasali Pride Mage, maybe? No, because that guy's going to get stopped here anyway, so just stagger for 4 is fine. I'll figure out what I'm going to get with this. Maybe... I don't know, it definitely should not be Polycranos, though. He's doing Jack. Stringer of Geist. Hero Blade holds pretty spicy. Eternal Witness is not the worst. I think I just get Hero Blade hold. He has to kill that thing. Yeah. In for 4. Yep. White, green. Alright, so now he's got to answer this thing. I got Stirring Wildwood on top, which is reasonable. If he doesn't answer this, he takes 12 the first attack. And then he untaps this, I think. So, in order to take 12. The key there was just getting a creature that can attack through Mazebeth. Oh, what does he have? He's got Go for a Throat. Okay. Creature? Nope. He's gonna block one of these and maze one of these, I assume. Doesn't block. Interesting. Mazed but didn't block. It's gonna pass. Down to 17. What else does he have? Hide this. Obsidad. It's kind of gross. He's got a blanket. There should not be a there, so say. So what do I have to do here? I have to block Obsidat. This guy. I could block with a bunch of things. Still going to attack with two dudes. This guy goes ultimate 7. I'll tie to Obsid at 3 turns. 4 turns. I'm assuming I get dealt any amount of damage beyond this, but maybe not. Maybe I should just plan for the full 5. Alright, I'm gonna go for this block. It really doesn't matter if he's got a removal spell or not. I want to make it. I still have a couple chump blockers after this. Even if it doesn't work out, he might have just not seen the land. I'm gonna block with Xaxes because if he has a removal spell, he'll just kill this and it won't matter. Oh, he just mazed with his own thing, sure. That's good for us, I guess. We got Maze with tapped. Let's see if we could capitalize on it. That's a big game. Oh, I can kill this with the Sundering Titan. Do I want to fight any of this stuff? No. Put that into my hand. Breaking face fetters here, obviously. I think I just want to keep this thing. I could go get Sundering Titan. Kill this. This. Because this is a swamp. But I also kill forest and a mountain. Not that it matters all that much. But if I just kill this face fetters, he's got this in play. I think that's best. And I burn this out with this guy. Oh, I should have tapped differently. That's fine. City Brass will ping me either way. I kind of don't want to tap it to get in for 3. I also need a blocker back. He's going to chump block. How do I feel about this? I could just get in for 3. Activate this. I'll just attack for 3 and not activate this. City of Brass deals 1 damage regardless of how it gets tapped. Actually, I could get in for 4 here. Let me think. No, it needs to be 3. I gotta block with that guy. He's jumping. So he's just got Obsidian, but he's got Phyrexian Ram pinging away. The fact that the jump here is kind of crappy. Now I need to go grab a Sundering Titan to kill that Mazewith. Play a Vorrath Stronghold, what the hell? Oh man. I attacking Domri. Could just let you attack Domri. No, I need to... Domri going ultimate is a pretty big game. I think I just have to go get Sundering Titan and play it. What's he gonna get back? Baleful Strength? I'd really like to be able to play this and the Sundering Titan. Maybe I could spike here. Let's see. Spike! Yes. Ooh, that's a big game too. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I mean, I do have to take a damage, but it's probably worth it. I get in a 10 damage to his face. And I have a Sundering Titan in play. Then next turn I could just play this Nearheath Pilgrim. Yeah. Dude, this game is intense. I can't kill him right now. I could get back Eternal Witness. Any of those options. Okay, I take one, which sucks, but it's got to be done. Choose a basic land of each type. Swamp. Alright, now we get in for a bunch. This blocks Obsidat, but he can get back Snapcaster. If he gets back Snapcaster, he can Preordain. That doesn't do anything. Get back Strix. That doesn't matter. Get back this, but he won't have any play in time for... Yeah, so let's attack for a bunch. It's the old Urborg hurting you. He could draw a removal spell and then I would die. I'll just do this for two. Just in case. I don't want to lose this game before I get this Pilgrim into playing game seven. Gain more because I have Domri if he plays a creature. I restricted some of his plays by blowing up some of his lands, but certainly not enough of them. Getting rid of Mazewith was big enough though. This game's been insane. What you putting back? Targeting Baleful Strix. Alright. Goes to 9. Baleful Strix, I could literally fight with a Domri, so that wouldn't be a great draw. It wouldn't be a great play for him. And he has to take a damage. Oh no, he can Mox Dime it. This is not a Baleful Strix. What is this? Oh my god. That did not just happen. I hate life so much. Man. I thought I played well, but I'll probably go look back and look at the tape and realize I could have taken an entirely different line with this deck. If I could have that Stirring Wildwood up, I don't know. I feel like that would involve me not going for a line. I don't know. How do I deal with that guy? Well, I have nothing, but I really don't have to deal with it. I have Court of Calling. That'll occasionally deal with it. Monstrosity can occasionally deal with it. Definitely with this Ravenous Baboons. Goodbye, Chandra. Oh, Chandra hits Strix, and actually, Chandra's pretty good. Goodbye, Flint of Boar. Trying to see what else I could theoretically cut. I mean, I could cut the quarter calling, but that would kind of defeat the purpose. And then I have to figure out if I want to bring in this guy. I don't think so. So that'll be my only change. Bring in a baboon. This is a baboon.